Hello, comrades, and welcome back to Ushanka Show. Sorry I'm wearing this silly hat all the time, but Comrade Major really likes this hat. Today I would like to talk to you a little bit about cars. And of course, we want to talk about Soviet cars. There's a little quiz for you. Just name at least one brand of Soviet car. Just one brand of Soviet car. Well, any ideas, any names, any brands? I don't think so. Well, maybe some of you can say, hey, Trabant. But this is East German car, which kind of became famous after the fall of the Berlin Wall. It became like a symbol of the difference. You got Audi and Mercedes-Benz and BMWs in West Germany. And then you have Trabant as the symbol of socialist Eastern Germany. Well, Soviet Union also had quite a few cars, and these are the cars we will talk about it. We're going to talk about Invalidka car, right here. We're going to talk about ZAZ, Zulu, Alpha, Zulu, Zaporozhets cars, like this. Now we will talk about Moskvich or Moscovite, AZLK. Right here. Of course, we have to mention Zhiguli or Lada, the most popular, the most desired car in Soviet Union, like this one. Of course, we have to talk about Volga. Volga, the car of Soviet government, Soviet police. And we had an old GAZ GAZ 21 like this, and then we have a newer ones like this. And you maybe started noticing there's a little bit resemblance between Soviet cars and some of the American cars. And I'm not sure who stole whose design. And of course, we have to talk about the absolute luxury of Soviet car manufacturers, Chaika. Like this. So, what do you think happens when the government decides everything from how many cars we have need to produce to how many combines, how much bread? It happens quite an interesting situation. You cannot just go out there and buy a car. This was what's going on in Soviet Union. It's huge country, biggest country in the world. But we had like five car factories where we're manufacturing just so many cars a year. So we had a horrible shortage of cars, which we call deficit. And the funny thing, well, now I live in America and I see advertising everywhere about 0% financing and 90 days MS cash. You'll buy a car regardless of your credit history. All these kind of gimmicks to lure people in to sell them a car. In Soviet Union, there were no money wasted on car advertising because cars were in such a tight supply. In fact, you have to wait up to 10 years if you didn't have the right connections to buy a car. I'm dead serious. I still remember my mom. She had a great plan for me. She said, after I'm done with high school and go to college, and after I'm done with college, the 9-year wait in Kiev was 9 years. So she one day she came home from work and she was all proud. She said, you know, I put you on the list to buy a car. In 9 years, it'll be our turn to buy a Lada. And by that time, you will finish high school, you'll finish college, you'll get married. And that time was the perfect time for you to buy a car. And by that time, you'll save some money to buy a car. Because you see, cars were also extremely expensive. For example, Lada, like this, was about 9,000 rubles. So let's call $9,000, right? Average person in Soviet Union was making about $150 to $200 a month, rubles, but we call it dollars. So $200 a month, car is $9,000. So let's see, 1 year you'll make, let's call it 2,500, right? So you need to work pretty much 4 years, almost 5 years to earn enough money to buy a car. So if you make in America $50,000, the price for the car to be on the same level as the price in the, for the car in Soviet Union, it would be about $200,000. So now you're making 50 grand, and there's the car, just a regular car. Look at this Lada. It's a manual transmission, no air conditioning, no power windows, everything is just basic, everything manual, no power locks, nothing. $200,000. And you need to wait 9 years just for the right to buy it. And you need to have that kind of insane money. So, of course, if anyone would manage to get a car, those were the really cool people. So there was not many cars around, and you could see at these pictures right here, then there were not really traffic jams in Soviet Union. Moscow, Kiev, St. Petersburg streets were literally empty. But we had a really good system of public transportation. We had beautiful subway system. Look at the pictures of the Moscow subway system, Metropolitan right here. Or pictures of Metropolitan in St. Petersburg right here. And then of course we had trolley buses like this. We had buses like that. We had these buses were called Garmoshka, which is accordion. It's a bus with a little trailer bus attached to it like this. And then of course we had tramways like this. So, and of course then we had electrichkas like this. So, as I mentioned, if you had a car in Soviet Union, you were a really cool guy. And right now when everyone can buy a car pretty much as easy as here in the United States, we have a horrible problem with traffic jams, with roads not being built, considering that everyone will have a car, and also we have issues with parking. If you look at these pictures, people have to park anywhere they can find a spot, on the grass, out on the sidewalks. It's just because when they were designing the cities in Soviet Union, they had a basic formula, and architects, they work by formulas. Okay, we have this building, 300 families, 10 families will have a car. So they have a parking lot for 10 cars for 300 apartment building. So this is the problem, which is really bad right now in any big city in Soviet Union, former Soviet Union, in Ukraine. It's just people have no room to park their cars. And you know, I didn't realize how much you guys, you Americans, have this car culture. It's because if you think about it, your trips with your parents when you were a kid, your first car when you were a teenager. My first car, I got it when I was 25. No, 28. This is when I get my first car, and I got it here in America. So I missed this whole bunch of, car culture memories that you guys have. Like one time, my wife, she's American. She asked me, like, remember those sweet moments of your childhood when you come home from the long trip and your parents carrying you, as you know, while you're asleep from the back seat in the car in the house? And I look at my wife like, my family never had a car. So I don't have those memories. So this one, I came to my realization how much I'm missing of American car culture. And my father-in-law, Gary Earhart, he's a big fan of old cars. Any old car we see on the road, for me, just, oh, that's a cool looking old car. He's like, oh no, this is 1939 suicide door, blah blah blah, Hudson or Pontiac or some other car. That, like, how do you know all these things? For me, just cool looking old car. And I'm trying to learn more about American culture, about all the things that relates to cars. But unfortunately, a lot of things I will never learn, because if you think, all your memories starting from the childhood, then of course when you're a teenager, your very first kiss probably happened in the car. I honestly have no idea, only can imagine how many young Americans lose their innocence in the backseat of the car. All those things, just I missed it completely. And like for my friends at work, they're trying to help me to learn a lot about American culture. They teach me a lot of things I never knew about. Sometimes it's funny, sometimes it's not. And one thing they told me, that they said, if you really want to understand American car culture, you need to experience this thing, which called, road rash? No. It's called, they said, you need to experience roadhead. While you experience the roadhead, you understand American culture fully. So I came home and asked my wife, is there any possibility we can experience roadhead so I can learn this American culture? But for some reason, she got really angry with me and she didn't talk to me for a couple of days, and I still have no idea what roadhead is. So I'm hoping one day I will learn and I'll experience, I'll be on the same level with you guys about American car culture. But now we kind of went off topic for a little bit, so we're gonna make next video more in details about Soviet cars. As I said, we'll start with this amazing Invalidka car, which was designed for handicapped people, and we go from there looking at all the Soviet cars. So I hope you enjoyed the show. Please like the video if you really liked it. Share it with your friends, and we'll see you next time. Thank you. Goodbye.